John Wiggins is the Vice President of Organizational Culture and Inclusion for the Toronto Raptors. I sat down with him to discuss his new role, why it's important, and what prompted him to speak out. Why you, John? Like, why do you, what do you think they saw in you? Not why, like, I know why.
yeah, I think it really was maybe one of two things. I think, you know, taking on the 905 and coming with an action plan and implementing something brand new for the organization 5 years ago. And I think we're kind of revisiting that again. How are we going to attack something that's really, really important, that's really going to be beneficial for everybody? And how can we implement that? I wanted to lead. That was the big thing. It wasn't just speaking on the conversations or on the Zoom calls or the dialogues that we were having. It was wanting to be a part of the change and lead it. So, you know, as I said, why don't you come lead it?
Were you apprehensive in that process at all about, you know, how much you should say, how vocal you should be?
Yeah, absolutely. When I saw some of the videos that were posted, you know, the initial thought was anger, but I didn't stay there very long, and it turned to, what can I do? And all I kept landing back on was, man, I work for Maple Leaf Sports and Entertainment and the Toronto Raptors, and those two platforms don't get much bigger in this country. So there was a sense of obligation and responsibility maybe to speak up on behalf of so many other people. So I was quivering over hitting that mute button when Masai was talking to us, and he kind of said, you know, this conversation will not die. And I didn't really agree with that. I just said, there's been so many times this has been happening, whether it was Trayvon Martin, Eric Gardner, and then the conversation just dies. And I was fearful. And I really said, I want to hold Masai and the rest of our group accountable that the conversation will continue, because if that's what he was committing to, that was the most important part for me.
What can we do? What can people, the public, people like me do to help you?
The big thing for me is I'm not the expert, but I want to know what's happening. Where can we contribute? What are the exact issues? The LGBT community, I want to talk to them and find out, you know, where can we be of assistance? How can we get involved? I can read up on Indigenous rights and find out, especially here in Canada, learn more about some of the brutal, heinous injustice that they're going through, but I don't know how we can help. So I think from the community standpoint, I'm almost listening and reaching out to as many people as possible to find our way forward.
What makes you tick, John? Like, what's something people don't know about you?
I just want to help. That's all this really comes down to. Whether it was the power, whether it was an AAU program, whether it's 905, I'm driven by just contributing to this game. And I used to call it barbershop talk, right? We go in the barbershop and we all talk about, I would do this, this person needs to do that, this is garbage. And then we get our haircut and we leave and we don't do anything. Well, I'm not that person. I just want to contribute to this game. I think the game gives opportunities to so many people, and that's really what drives me every single morning, is how can I help this game here in Canada be great?
What would be on the back of your jersey?
Oh, great question. Equity is a huge one for me right now. Equity speaks more to giving everybody what they need so that we become on an even playing field. A lot of, you know, the shirts we see say equality, and equality speaks to the fact that we're all starting from an even playing field and everybody's not. So I think I'd like to push that message around. No, we're not looking necessarily for equality, we're looking for equity, right? Like, if I'm tall and you're short, I need to give you something more than what the tall person has to make us even. If not, Black Lives Matter for sure. I think it still needs to resonate. It still needs to be said. It's a movement and it's a conversation that, you know, a lot of people still don't seem to understand why that's being said. And I'd love to keep that conversation going.
And I appreciate you doing this, and good luck for your role and in the future. And it's always great sitting down, seeing you. Let's do this.
You know it is. 100%, the new COVID bump.
I appreciate you, man.
No, thanks for having me. Appreciate you, Randy.